To understand just how powerful these explosions were, all you need to do is look at the damage behind me. This was a two-story temporary office building that would have collapsed on people had the explosions happened during office hours. Thankfully, it happened late at night on Wednesday evening. And there is new video surfacing, and I want you to watch because it was taken just a couple of hundred meters in an apartment building overlooking the blast site. And just watch and listen to what happened when the explosion and the shockwave hit. Just incredible and terrifying to imagine what it was like inside the homes of thousands of people in the immediate vicinity of the explosion. There were people living at this site here as well in temporary housing, and they described their homes falling around them. Now the biggest fear for people is what has been left behind from this disaster in terms of the environmental impact. The Chinese government says that the air quality in this area and other areas has returned to normal. They say it's completely safe, only with slightly heightened levels of ammonia right by the blast site. But even they say that is safe in short doses. But one thing that they're not sure about is chemicals and toxins that may have been launched into the air and then sprinkled onto the ground in the surrounding area of the explosion. They've already acknowledged that there were 700 tons of sodium cyanide. This releases a potentially deadly gas. And there's a lot of fear about what could happen if this particular compound is exposed to water. And there's rain in the forecast for Tianjin. So the government's trying to send troops. They have 2,000 troops that are scouring the area, trying to find sodium cyanide. They're trying to neutralize it with hydrogen peroxide or build a structure over it to prevent it from interacting with water if it were to rain. But that's not good enough for some people who own homes in this area. They say they will never feel safe again.
I just want an answer from the government. Are the officials corrupt or what? Why do they build a hazardous chemical warehouse near our home without telling us? Who would want to live next to a ticking time bomb? No one.
Those homeowners are asking the government to buy back their apartments, to pay them for their housing, saying that it might be the government's fault for allowing the chemical facility to sit so close to people's homes. Meanwhile, China's highest legal authority is announcing that they will pursue criminal charges of not only criminal negligence, but also possibly abuse of power against anybody who allowed this to happen, who allowed this shipping port to operate and to have so many dangerous toxins sitting together, just waiting, literally, to explode. Meanwhile, they continue to search for possible survivors, but it seems unlikely, and with at least 95 still missing, 85 of them firefighters, the death toll sadly could and is expected to continue to rise in the days to come. Will Ripley, CNN, Tianjin, China.